Welcome to the Angular Floating Action Button tutorial. The Syncfusion Angular Floating Action Button is a circular or rounded button that appears to float over all the contents of a web page to trigger the primary screen action. In this video, I will show you how to create an Angular app and add the Syncfusion Angular Floating Action Button component. I will show you how to integrate the Floating Action Button into the Angular ListView component. You will also see how to add and position an icon in the button, change the button position, and customize button styles. Let me start with the application creation process. I'm going to create an Angular application using the Angular CLI tool. Make sure you have installed the latest version of Node.js. First, open Visual Studio Code and install the Angular CLI using the npm install -g at angular/cli command. As I have already installed it, I am skipping this step. Next, I will create a new Angular project. I use the ng new project name command and name my project example. I am creating a project with the option to add a CSS style sheet, so I choose the CSS option. The project creation has started, and it is creating an Angular project along with its dependencies. Now, let me navigate to the project folder to add the Syncfusion Angular Floating Action Button component. Install the Syncfusion Angular Buttons package using the npm install at syncfusion/ej2angularbuttons --save command. This will install the package with its dependencies. The application is now ready to use. Before using the Syncfusion component, I need to register the trial license key. I open the main.ts file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. To learn how to generate this license key, refer to the link in the description below. The application is now configured to use Syncfusion components. Next, I navigate to the app component TS file and import the fab module from the Syncfusion Angular Buttons package. Then register it within the imports array of the component section. As I said, I want to integrate the floating action button into the list component. So, let me install the Syncfusion Angular Lists package using the npm install at syncfusion/ej2angularlists --save command. Then, I import the ListView module from the Syncfusion Angular Lists package. Then register it within the imports array of the component section. To apply styles to the floating action button and list, navigate to the style.css file and add CSS references by importing the material theme. Move to the app component HTML file and remove its default content. I add the floating action button by adding the button element with the EJ's fab attribute and set the content as add. Then I add the Syncfusion Angular list view to this application by pasting the code from an existing application. In the app component TS file, I have defined the data source for the list view component and also defined the border style here. To learn how to add this Syncfusion list view component to an Angular application, refer to the documentation link in the description below. Next, I save the changes and run the application using the ng serve command. The list view component is rendered with the provided data, and the floating action button is rendered at its default bottom right position on the page. Now, let me integrate this floating action button into the list view. I add an ID property to the list view and set an appropriate value. I assign it to the target property of the floating action button Checking now, the floating action button is integrated into the ListView component. Next, I will show you how to add a new list item by clicking this button. I add the click event to the button with the event handler on click. Then I define the onClick event handler in the app component TS file. Within it, I create a new item with text and ID fields. To add this item to the ListView component, I need its instance. So in the app component HTML file, add a reference attribute for this list component, using which I will create an instance to dynamically access the props and methods of a list. Moving back to the app component TS file, I first import the view child decorator, then import the list view component from the Syncfusion Angular Lists package. Using the view child decorator, I get the reference to the list view element. Then, I invoke the built-in add item method using the list view component instance and add the newly created item. You can see the new item added to the list when the add button is clicked. To add an icon to the button, add the icon CSS property and set the predefined classes the icons and new plus to it. You can now see the plus icon displayed at the button. By default, the icon displays to the left of the text. You can also display it to the right, top, or bottom. To change the icon position to the right, set the icon position property to right. Look here, the icon is on the right. The default position of the floating action button is bottom right. You can also place it at the top left, top center, top right, middle, or bottom. To demonstrate this, I set the position property to top right. See, the button renders as specified. Finally, I will show how to apply built-in styles to the button. The default style is primary. I want to render the button without any background, so I add the CSS class property and set the outline class to it. Now you can see the button renders with the outline style. In this video, I showed you how to add the Syncfusion Angular Floating Action Button component to an Angular application. You have also seen how to integrate the floating action button into the Angular List View component, display and position icons, and change the button's position and styles. To see a working example, download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link to check if you qualify for a free license key to use our Angular products through our community license. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.